Welcome to an advanced preview of Switch 13, which will be released at the end of August 2015. The following video is one in a series of clips designed to showcase what new and existing users of Switch can look forward to in our upcoming release of Switch 13. The subject of this video is the new web messages feature, sure to make your interactions with Switch much easier. The evolution of Switch messages has reached its most powerful phase in Switch 13, combining accessibility and comprehensiveness in a web browser-based Switch message viewer. From the Switch designer, simply click the Messages button, which now opens a web browser, and all related Switch messages will be displayed. Share this URL and gain remote access to your Switch messages. All that's needed is your favorite web browser. No additional software or licensing is necessary to use this new feature. Messages can be chronologically reordered from most recent to oldest, or oldest to most recent, by clicking on the date and time column heading and selecting the desired order. You'll also notice the arrow icon change directions. In this same column heading, you can also apply filters that will allow further control over messages being displayed based on a particular period in time as selected in the filter. For example, here I've filtered my messages to display only those messages captured during February 9th and 10th, and as you can see, my display is adjusted accordingly. Additionally, notice the filter icon now displayed in this column heading. The remaining column headings will also allow for various types of filtering specific to the type of information contained within. For example, you'll see that most columns can be alphabetically reordered. And notice how the Type column heading will allow you to filter on single or multiple types of Switch messages. In the remaining columns, enter specific data into the Contains Any field to filter on that text. Filtering settings can be saved by bookmarking the URL to easily return to a specific filtered overview. To clear any applied filters, simply click the Clear Filters button in the upper right corner of this window. In the same area, you can also enable the ability to wrap text for longer Switch messages by clicking the Wrap Text button. Here you can see the results. And clicking the Export Log button will allow the viewer to save the displayed messages as a CSV file. You can also enable or disable the auto-refresh feature, or change to one of the 5 available languages. Debug messages are quickly accessible by first going to the Switch Preferences, Logging, and here, set the option Log Debug Messages to Yes. Now, click on Messages again, click on the Type column, and include or filter debug messages. When clicking the Messages button from the Switch Designer, users will immediately be directed to the browser display, but when logging in remotely using the URL, it will be necessary to have user and permission credentials established on the Switch server. On the Switch server, click the Users button in the Switch Designer. Select an existing user or create a new user, and notice the new option for web browser access. Set this accordingly per user. In the Switch Preferences, visit the Web Service option to set further details related to the web browser-based Switch messages. You'll see the option to change the default port, select from 2 different protocols, notice the additional options if set to HTTPS, and lastly, to include a privacy page link if desired. Thank you for watching. We hope that you found this video useful, and be sure to watch all the videos in this series as the excitement builds towards our latest release of Switch, version 13.